ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस बेसिक्स ऑफ आईआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। आईआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी मींस इंफ्रारेड स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। इंफ्रारेड, सो वील यूज इंफ्रारेड रेडिएशंस। द एनर्जी ऑफ इंफ्रारेड रेडिएशंस इज सफिशियंट टू कॉज ट्रांजिशन बिटवीन वेरियस वाइब्रेशनल लेवल्स। ओके, मीन्स अवर मॉलिक्यूल विल बी एक्साइटेड फ्रॉम वन वाइब्रेशनल लेवल टू अदर वाइब्रेशनल लेवल। सो इट इन्वॉल्व्स वाइब्रेशनल ट्रांजिशंस, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड वाइब्रेशनल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू आईआर रेडिएशंस, द आईआर रीजन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 2.5 माइक्रोमीटर टू 15 माइक्रोमीटर। दिस विल बी अवर एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट फॉर वाइब्रेशनल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। द रीजन बिलो 2.8 टू 2.5 माइक्रोमीटर इज कॉल्ड नियर आईआर रीजन, नियर इंफ्रारेड रीजन, एंड फ्रॉम 15 टू 200 माइक्रोमीटर इज कॉल्ड फार इंफ्रारेड रीजन। ओके, नो इफ वी सी द डिफरेंस 2.5 टू 15, द रीजन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 2.5 माइक्रोमीटर टू 15 माइक्रोमीटर। दिस इज वेरी स्मॉल डिफरेंस, सो पीक्स in this area will overlap with each other because the difference is very small. So in IR spectroscopy, if we take spectra versus wavelength, then peaks will be very near to each other, or sometimes they will overlap with each other, so interpretation will be very difficult. Okay, so we don't take lambda or wavelength. Okay, in case of IR spectroscopy, we take IR spectrum in terms of wave number. Now, what is wave number? Wave number is basically 1 upon lambda, okay, 1 upon wavelength. So, 15 micrometer corresponds to 667 centimeter inverse, and 2.5 micrometer corresponds to 4000 centimeter inverse. So, now difference is increased, difference has been increased. Firstly, it was from 2.5 micrometer to 15 micrometer. Now it is 667 to 4000. Okay, journal IR spectrum we take in region 400 to 4000 centimeter inverse. This is the range for IR spectrum journaling. Okay, so first of all, what we have seen that in case of IR spectroscopy, vibrational transitions are involved. So it is also called vibrational spectroscopy. Okay, and we take IR spectrum in terms of wave number, not wavelength, because the area is very small. Okay, so we take IR spectrum in case of in terms of wave number. Okay, so now coming to the principle of IR spectroscopy, as I have already told you that IR radiation cause vibrational transition, that is transition between various vibrational levels from ground state to higher vibrational state. Now we know that rotational energy is very less as compared to vibrational energy. So whenever we will give IR radiation along with vibrational transitions, some rotational transitions will also occur, because rotational energy is very small as compared to vibrational transitions. So it is also called vibrational rotational spectroscopy, because rotational transitions are also accompanied with vibrational transitions. Okay, now principle of, what is main principle of IR spectroscopy? Only those vibrations which are accompanied by change in dipole moment will absorb in IR region. What I mean to say, only those vibration which will involve change in dipole moment will be IR active. Now what does this mean? To understand this, first of all we'll see molecular vibration, types of molecular vibration. In molecules there are different types of vibration, mainly classified as stretching and bending vibrations. Okay, now what is stretching vibration? Stretching vibration is basically atoms do not change their bond axis. Okay, this can't move like this, it will remain in only this axis, but this distance can increase or decrease. Distance between atoms increases or decreases, but atoms remain in same bond axis, they never leave their bond axis. Okay, so this atom will remain in this axis, although this distance can increase or decrease. So So such type of vibrations are called stretching vibration. Second type of molecular vibration is bending vibrations. In bending vibration, we can change the bond axis, means bond angle may change. These atoms can change the bond axis. They can move like this. So they can change bond axis. Okay, position of atoms change with respect to bond axis. Okay, so stretching, bond axis remains same, and bending, there is change of bond axis. Okay, so now coming to now stretching, for stretching vibration frequency will be higher than bending. Okay, why? Because we know that to stretch a spring, more energy is required than to bend it. Okay, so stretching vibration will be will occur at higher frequency. Okay, now in case of stretching vibration, types of stretching vibration, there are again two types of stretching vibration: symmetric stretch and asymmetric stretch. Now what is symmetric stretch? Movement with respect to particular atom, atoms move in same direction. For example, in this case, both atoms are moving away from central atom. I have shown by arrows, both atoms are moving away from central atom, and this is symmetric stretch. In this also, both atoms are moving towards central atom. Okay, so it is also symmetric stretch. Symmetric stretch is atoms move with respect to a particular atom in same direction, either away or towards it. Okay, for example, this is my carbon monoxide molecule, carbon dioxide molecule. It is linear. Okay, and dipole moment is zero. We know that dipole moment of carbon dioxide is zero because of its linear shape. Dipole moment of this bond will cancel out dipole moment of this bond. Okay, now symmetric stretch, taking the example of symmetric stretch, we are moving both oxygen away from central carbon. Okay, so both oxygen are moving away from central atom. So both bonds are elongated to same extent. So again dipole moment will be zero. Okay, so this vibration, symmetrical stretch of CO2, there is no change in dipole moment. Dipole moment is still the same. It was zero, it is again zero. So in principle of IR spectroscopy, we have seen that only those vibration which will involve change in dipole moment will be IR active. So this means symmetric stretch of CO2 involves no change in dipole moment, so it will be IR inactive. So this was what I have told you in principle of IR spectroscopy. Now coming to asymmetric stretch, one atom will approach the central atom and other will move away from it. Okay, one atom approaches while other departs from it. So this is asymmetric stretch. Now again, taking the case of carbon dioxide, one atom is moving away from carbon, other is moving towards carbon. So this bond will get compressed and this bond will get elongated. Now dipole moment will not be zero because dipole moment is unequal in both the direction, so it will not be equal to zero. So asymmetric stretch of CO2 will involve change in dipole moment. Okay, because there is change in dipole moment, so this will be IR active. Okay, so this was stretching vibration. We have seen there are two types of stretching vibrations, symmetric and asymmetric. Okay, now coming to bending vibrations, there are four types of bending vibration. Two are in plane vibrations, means plane of atoms will remain same, and two are out of plane vibrations, means ki atoms will change their plane. Okay, so in plane vibrations, scissoring, like atoms move like scissor. How a scissor works? Either atoms approach each other or move from each other. This is how does scissor work. Okay, so two atoms approach each other or move away from each other, but these are not changing their plane. These are in same plane, they are not moving like this. Plane is not changing. Okay, plane is same. Two atoms either approach each other or move away from each other. So such type of bending vibration is called scissoring vibration. Next is rocking vibration. Two atoms move in same direction, either like this or this. Okay, two atoms move in same direction. So these were in plane vibrations. Now out of plane vibrations in bending are wagging and twisting. Now what is wagging? Wagging is basically two atoms will move either upwards or downwards, okay, simultaneously. I have shown here plus signs means both the atoms are moving upwards, okay. So both the atoms will move up or down the plane with respect to central atom simultaneously. Both will move upward or both will move downward, okay. Twisting, in case of twisting, one atom will move upward and one will move downward. So I have shown here by taking plus and negative sign. Plus is it is moving upward the plane and it is moving behind the plane, okay. So how to remember this? SRIP, spectroscopy, rest in peace. It means scissoring and rocking are in plane vibrations, okay. So now coming to these were vibration, different types of vibrations, stretching and bending. In case of stretching, we have seen symmetric stretch and asymmetric stretch, and in case of bending, we have seen scissoring and rocking were in plane and wagging and twisting were out of the plane, okay. Now coming to vibrational frequency. Now although IR spectrum we take in terms of wave number, but we know that wave number is directly proportional to frequency. So we'll take frequency, we'll use term frequency, not wave number, because these are directly proportional, okay. Although everywhere frequency will be written, but you have to understand that we are talking about wave number, okay. So now coming to vibrational frequency. Vibrational frequency is given by this formula. Nu bar is equal to 1.2 pi c k upon mu. K is force constant. Stronger is the bond, stronger will be the force constant. And mu is reduced mass. Okay. So we have seen here that vibrational frequency is directly proportional to force constant. And it is inversely proportional to reduced mass. Heavier is our molecule, lower will be the vibrational frequency. Okay. So that's why C triple bond C, C double bond C, and C single bond C. Now since force constant of triple bond will be higher, so its vibrational frequency will be higher as compared to double bond, which in turn will be higher than single bond. Okay. Now this is iodoalkane, bromoalkane, and chloroalkane. Since iodine is heavier in mass, iodine is more as compared to bromine, so this will absorb at lower frequency because vibrational frequency is inversely proportional to mass, okay. Then bromo, then chloro. Now coming to factors influencing vibrational frequencies. First of all, we'll talk about fundamental vibration and overtone. Now what are fundamental vibrations? We know that in a molecule there will be different vibrational levels, okay. Now higher frequency, higher radiations will cause vibrational transition, excitation from one vibrational level to higher vibrational level, okay. Now if my molecule is getting excited from ground state V1, from lowest ground state vibration level to second vibration level, then it is called fundamental vibration. If transition is taking place from V1 to V2, then it is called fundamental vibration. But if the transition is taking place to higher levels, V1 to V3, V1 to V4, okay, my molecule is excited from ground state to higher, not second excited, but third excited to fourth excited, higher excited state, then it is called overtone, okay. So what is fundamental vibration? When excitation is taking place from ground state to first excited state, then it is fundamental vibration, and if it is taking place to higher vibration levels, then it is overtone, okay. Now coming to coupled vibration and Fermi resonance. Now there will be some value of CH frequency. If we take methylene group, now there are two CH bonds, we'll get two frequencies. if one for symmetric stretch and one for asymmetric stretch. Okay, we have both bonds CH bond. Okay, but we'll have two frequencies, one for symmetric stretch and one for asymmetric stretch. So we say that these vibrations have been coupled. These vibrations are coupled vibrations. Okay, so these are called coupled vibrations. Now coming to Fermi resonance. What is Fermi resonance? Basically, if in a molecule there is some fundamental vibration, this is any fundamental vibration, this is another vibration's overtone. Okay, overtone of second vibration. This is fundamental vibration of one bond, this is overtone of second bond. Okay, now what happens? If the energy of these will match, these are of almost equal energy, what happens? If first of all our molecule is excited from this level to this, it will show fundamental vibration of one vibration. Okay, when it will jump back, it can give its energy to cause overtone of second vibration, because their energy matches, their energies are equal. So this will give its energy to cause excitation of this. Okay, it can again de-excite and give energy to this. Molecule transfers its energy from fundamental to overtone and overtone to fundamental again and again, like pendulum. So this resonance mixes their character. Now each level is partly fundamental and partly overtone. Such type of resonance is called Fermi resonance. Okay, now coming to factors affecting vibrational frequencies, electronic effect. This is very important effect. Now we know that we will take example of carbonyl compounds. This is my carbonyl group, C double bond O. Because oxygen is electronegative, so it will withdraw some electrons towards itself more. So where oxygen is partial negative charge and carbon is partial positively charged. Okay, so because of this withdrawing of electrons toward oxygen, this bond will acquire partial single bond character. Okay, because now these electrons, pi electrons, are moving toward oxygen, so this bond will acquire partial single bond character. Okay, its frequency will decrease. Now what happens if we attach some electron releasing group to carbonyl group? It will give its electron to carbon. These electrons will be more pulled towards oxygen. So plus psi effect groups with plus psi effect will enhance single bond character, and our frequency of carbonyl will decrease because single bond is weaker than double bond. Okay, and if we attach some electron withdrawing substituent, when we attach some electron withdrawing substituent, electronegative substituent, it will withdraw electrons toward itself, it will attract electrons toward itself. So these electrons, carbon will get electron deficient, it will not give electrons easily to oxygen, so it will increase double bond character. So groups with minus I effect will enhance double bond character of carbonyl, so they will increase carbonyl frequency. That's why this is formaldehyde. When I attach methyl, this is acetaldehyde, we have replaced hydrogen with methyl. Methyl is electron donating group. It will enhance single bond character. So frequency will decrease from 1750 to 1745. And if we take acetone, now there are two methyl groups, frequency will further decrease to 1715. Okay. In the same manner, mesomeric effect or resonance effect will occur. The groups which will be electron withdrawing will enhance double bond character, and groups which will be electron releasing will enhance single bond character on a similar way. So if we take example of this, now here carbonyl we have attached NH2, we are taking benzamide. Okay, and in case of this we have attached OCH3. Now again, both of these are electron releasing group because of resonance. Okay, lone pair of nitrogen will shift here, this will acquire partial double bond character, and this will acquire single bond character similarly here. So carbonyl frequency will decrease in both the cases. But see, in case of benzamide it is 1693, and in case of this compound it is 1730. It is much lower. Why this is so? Because nitrogen is less electronegative. Because of less electronegativity of nitrogen, its electrons can easily be donated. because it has less tendency to hold the electrons, so these will be easily donated. So here single bond connector will be more, but oxygen is electronegative, it will not give its electrons easily. So this resonance is difficult to observe. Okay, so here double bond connector will be more, that's why here frequency is high. Now second factor, another factor which will affect frequency is hydrogen bonding. Now what happens, suppose I have taken example of HF molecule. Now this is one HF molecule, this is other HF molecule. There will be hydrogen bonding between this hydrogen of one molecule and fluorine of other molecule. Okay, now because of this hydrogen bonding, what happens when this hydrogen bonding is taking place, this bond is getting weaker because now fluorine is getting attached to other hydrogen. This fluorine is getting attached to other hydrogen. So this bond is getting weaker. When this bond is getting weaker, so there will be decrease in frequency. Hydrogen bonding brings about remarkable downward frequency shift. It will decrease the frequency. Okay. Now, hydrogen bonding is concentrated dependent, concentration dependent. More is the concentrated solution, more will be the hydrogen bonding, more will be the downward shift. So we can diminish the effect of hydrogen bonding by diluting the solution. Now taking the example of NH and OH, in case of NH frequency is 3500 centimeter inverse, in case of OH it is 3300 centimeter inverse. Why this is so? Because oxygen is more electronegative, so it can strongly form hydrogen bonds, so its frequency will be lowered. Nitrogen is less electronegative, so less hydrogen bonding, so its frequency will be more. Okay, now we can differentiate between inter and intramolecular hydrogen bonding by IR. Why? Because intramolecular, what is intramolecular hydrogen bonding? Hydrogen bonding within the same molecule, like this, within the same molecule. Now within the same molecule, so it will be not be concentration dependent. Okay, intramolecular hydrogen bonding is not concentration dependent, intermolecular is concentration dependent. So we want to see whether in a molecule there is intermolecular hydrogen bonding or intramolecular hydrogen bonding. What will we do? We'll dilute the solution. If there is shift of peak, then we'll say that our frequency is concentration dependent, means it is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, and in case of intra, there will be no effect. So in this video we'll do only this. In next video we'll discuss more about IR spectroscopy. Okay.